Hello friends, in last days I bought an element of a e-commerce photography of essential oil, and these are in the small bottles with the dropper. It is a very easy shoot in white background, but the main challenge of the assignment was the scratchy cover of the bottles. All 34 bottles have the scratches. Those were not able to remove with the dust and scratch filters, so I decided to paint the golden metallic part of the bottle. Let's watch. I have already opened the image on Photoshop workspace, so I am selecting a object selection tool and selecting the cover area only. To refine the selection, I am clicking a right mouse menu and select make work path. Now I am selecting a pen tool from the toolbar, or you can also use P shortcut. I found some issues in the selection, so I am doing manually point to point with the pen tool. After refining the selection, open the Path tab in the Layer panel and activate the selection by clicking on the path by holding Ctrl in the Windows or Command in the Mac. After selection activated, I am creating a new layer by clicking on the New Layer icon in the Layer panel. After that, I am selecting a gradient tool from the Tool panel and select the basic black to white from the option bar and select the Liner Gradient option next to the gradient picker. I am clicking on the basic gradient. A small window will pop up. Here you can change the color according to the golden tones. Here are a slider where you can set the shadow, midtone and highlight colors. So first I click on a dark button and then click on the color box and pick the dark golden color with the dropper. Then I am clicking on the white button and click on the color box and pick the lighter golden color. After little adjustment, click OK. Cover was painted with a nice golden gradient. Now I am creating a new curve adjustment layer and clipping on the gradient layer by clicking in the center of the curve adjustment and gradient layer by hold on option in the Mac or Alt in the Windows and hover your mouse between the two top layers in the layer panel. You can also use the shortcut by selecting both layers by using Command plus Option plus G in the Mac or Control plus Alt plus G in the Windows. By doing so, your other layers will not be affected by adjusting curves. After that, I am creating a new hue and saturation layer to adjust the golden color. But it looks like a painting, so I am reducing its opacity 100% to 78% to look natural. You can see scratches were hide under the gradient. Just adjusting hue and saturation again. Now I have 33 more bottles with the scratches. If I do the same on the every bottle, it will take more time and I have to create all layers for the every image. In this case, the cover is same for each bottle, so I decided to use same cover on the each image. First I creating snapshot by using Ctrl plus Alt plus Shift plus E in the Windows or Command plus Alt plus Shift plus E in the Mac. Then I selected the dropper with the cover part with the object selection tool. It is the best part of the object selection tool is that it can select only that area that you want to select. In subject selection, Photoshop select entire subject. Selection is looking perfect, so I copy the selection by going to edit menu and select copy and pasting on newly created document. When you create a new document, Photoshop automatically give the option of the same size of the selection you made. Now you have a dropper with the cover in the new document that you can use in any new image. I am opening the image where I have already shoot with the three bottles. I also save time, didn't shoot single bottle, I shoot three bottles in one shot. So I selected desired bottle with the object selection tool and pasted in the new document with the white background. Selection is perfect except the dropper part. but I am not worried about the cover. First, I am transforming the bottle and using Ctrl plus T in the Windows or Command plus T in the Mac to rotate, make it straight. After that, I am removing the spot of the flash by using Content Aware Fill. If you want to know more about Content Aware Fill, I have added a card above. For removing small spots and lines, I am using Spot Healing Brush by creating a new layer. Your option should be set Sample All Layers on option bar. If you use Spot Healing Brush on the same layer, you can't remove the changes that you made. By creating a new layer, you will work non-destructive way, so your original layer keeps saved. You can't use Spot Healing Brush on all area because its working depends on the samples. Sometimes it does not pick the right sample. So other area, I am using Clone Stamp tool by creating another new layer. Option should be All Layers in the option bar. Use Alt plus click in the Windows or Option plus click in the Mac to take sample and paint over the desired area. Now I am creating a new curve adjustment layer for the complete image. After enhancing the details by using auto option and adjusting the highlights and shadows. Now I am copying the cover from the document where we pasted before. I am pasting it in new bottle's document and placing on the cover of the new bottle. I reduce opacity 100% to 50% so I can place exact on the cover of the new bottle. After placing, I am again increasing its opacity 50% to 100%. Now I am selecting a bottle layer and erasing the cover of a new bottle so that any uneven area will not disturb a new cover. New cover was placed in the place of scratchy cover. New cover has some part of the old bottle, so I am creating a white mask and using black brush and paint over the area that you can show of the new bottle image. I am decreasing again opacity of a new cover image to see the placement. I found it needs little adjustment, so I am again transform the cover by using Ctrl plus T in Windows or Command plus T in the Mac. Little more adjustment needed, that I am doing the same. You can see how the cover was scratchy. After placing the new cover by using gradient tool, scratches were hide and also look natural. That's all for today. Soon I will come with the new tutorial. Thanks for watching.